Jimmy Lai is the billionaire owner of Apple Daily, the only opposition newspaper in Hong Kong.
I'm a born rebel. I have a rebellious character.
He's the most high-profile critic of Beijing to be arrested under Hong Kong's new national security law. Since his release on bail, he's given us unprecedented access. Jimmy and his reporters fear they're living on borrowed time.
You're so scaring of getting in jail any time.
China is tightening its grip on the city.
Fear is the most inexpensive and convenient way of ruling people and controlling people.
You must fear some things, for your family, for Hong Kong, for your loved ones.
Hong Kong last summer. 200 police officers are raiding the newsroom of Apple Daily. They've arrested its owner, Jimmy Lai. It's a show of strength from the Chinese authorities, which they hoped would silence the protest movement. Days on, crowds are starting to gather outside a police station in Mong Kok. They're hoping to see the release of Jimmy Lai, an icon of Hong Kong's pro-democracy movement. Finally, he's released on bail. A moment of open protest. Then police move in. Since the introduction of the new national security law, anyone could be investigated by the authorities. Critics, protesters, even journalists like me.
Come here! Okay. Come here! I'm investigating you! Okay.
A month after Jimmy was released on bail, we met at his mansion in Kowloon.
Do you think about the contrast between this and the prospects of living
in prison? This is just living my life peacefully. But if I'm in jail, I'm living my life meaningfully.
Jimmy was born in mainland China, but was smuggled into Hong Kong as a child. By his 20s, he had built a fashion empire, becoming one of Hong Kong's richest tycoons.
I come here with $1. I got everything I have because of this place. You know, a wonderful family. You know, they're very supportive. If this is the payback time, this is my redemption.
You must fear some things for your family, for Hong Kong, for your loved ones.
Yes. I do have fear. You're right.
In 1989, Jimmy watched as China cracked down on a student-led protest in Beijing. Within a few years, he'd set up Apple Daily, a brash tabloid critical of the Chinese Communist Party.
You can see in some ways Apple Daily is much more than just a newspaper. You can see how closely associated it is with the protest movement.
I'm joining Apple Daily photographer KT on China's National Day. This time last year, Hong Kong saw some of the most violent demonstrations since the protest movement began. But protesting is now risky in Hong Kong.
As there are a lot of police here, it seems that it is not possible for people to take any action.
Activists start to appear. But every time a confrontation emerges, the police raise the blue flag. It's a warning to say they're about to use force. There are multiple arrests, and some seem arbitrary.
You can use your eyes to look at them. I don't believe they are protesters.
The police search anyone they suspect of being a protester, especially the young. But they also target the press.
So you can see that we are now stuck in the middle. We have two police at the two sides, and you simply don't know why we are trapped here.
So we're now late in the evening. They've just raised another blue flag for the day.
By the end of the day, around 100 people have been arrested. It's Thursday morning, and on the ground floor of the Apple Daily newsroom, Jimmy Lai is preparing for his weekly live stream.
Hey, good morning, everybody. This is a very, very nice day in Hong Kong today. And we are very lucky to have Paul Wagerwitz from DC to talk to us.
He's still on bail, yet Jimmy is speaking to prominent political figures on a weekly basis.
Yeah, I think the freedom of speech is in danger here in Hong Kong.
It's a risky move.
We share the Western value.
For Jimmy, the fate of Hong Kong rests on the West's approach to China. He praises Trump's hardline stance against the CCP, the Chinese Communist Party. With the presidential elections just a few weeks away, Apple Daily is sending KT to cover the story. Tonight, he's reflecting on his year of covering the protests.
It is very important that everyone, if they have a chance to look at these kind of pictures, and they have to ask themselves why these youngsters have to go into the streets, why they have to do this, why they were there, what they are doing.
Do you feel it's possible when you come back from America, Apple Daily might not even exist?
Yeah, I just try to do my job every day, treat it as the last day of working in Apple Daily.
It's US election day, and the newsroom is watching the results come in.
If Biden is like Obama, we are screwed.
Morning. Morning, hey. How are you?
We go out and breakfast?
We've had a tip-off that Jimmy Lai might be detained by the police later today. So he returned to Kowloon to meet him.
Yeah, that was it.
He suspects he may be kept in overnight.
That's why I dress like this today, just if it's overnight, it's more convenient. You know, I don't even have a suit with a shoestring because they take it all off.
So do you think it's possible that you're not released on bail?
Anything's possible now in Hong Kong. You know, I just don't want to think about it because, you know, your imagination can carry you to really some hopeless situation. You know, if they can induce fear in you, that's the easiest way to control you. That's the cheapest way to control you and the most effective way. And they know it and they're very good at it.
Hours after we finish filming, Jimmy Lai is charged with fraud and colluding with foreign powers. He's denied bail.
Thank you so much.
This is Jimmy Lai's last interview as a free man.
Thank you.
Katie is back from covering the US elections.
Let's go.
And has been assigned to cover the trial of Jimmy Lai.
Hi, morning.
His first task is to get a shot of Jimmy leaving the detention centre.
Yo, you have to climb over the trees.
How does it feel being back in Hong Kong?
It seems like a totally different city right now. It's not Hong Kong we used to know.
Jimmy is taken to the prison van surrounded by guards.
You know, by looking at his picture, he looks like he's really committing some very serious crime. Handcuffed him and the chains around his waist. It's like, is it a murderer? We suppose we have the human rights protected under the basic law in Hong Kong. But practically, you don't feel you're protected. Practically, you feel paranoid, but you're frightened. You're so scared of getting in jail any time.
According to Beijing, the charges against Jimmy are equal to treason, and the prosecutor has compared the seriousness of his crimes with murder. He now faces potential life in prison, a sentence that would make him one of China's most high-profile dissidents.